गुड मॉर्निंग व्यूअर्स, वेलकम टू बायो सिनेमा चैनल। आई एम वेरी हैप्पी बी इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू अगेन टू एक्सप्लेन वन मोर टॉपिक, द अब्सॉर्प्शन ऑफ वाटर एंड मिनरल्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ रूट हेयर्स इन द प्लांट्स। यूजुअली इन अवर बॉडी देयर इज अ ब्लड सर्कुलेट सिस्टम विच कैन ट्रांसपोर्ट ए वाइड वेरायटी ऑफ सब्सटेंसेस, but in the case of plants how it can be operated, let us see the information related to the absorption of water and minerals with the help of root hairs. You know the topic is transportation . If you see the plant root system, each root system of any plant is having small hair-like projections on the lateral roots, and those hair-like projections on the lateral roots are generally termed as root hairs. This black colored hair-like structures, which are very thin, are generally called as root hairs. And these root hairs are covered with very thin membrane. And usually, the root system is inside the soil, and the roots are surrounded with the soil water existing in between the soil particles, and this soil water is having a wide variety of salts and minerals along with the water, and that is absorbed by the primary structures of the root system in most of the plants named as root hairs. This is the soil water with a wide variety of salts and minerals, and these are the root hairs which are surrounding the soil water, and the soil water is existing in between the gaps of the soil particles. Then how they are able to absorb the water from the soil and transporting into the lateral roots, from the lateral roots to tap root, from the tap root to the aerial part of the plant named as shoot system. Let us see in detail about the process. These are the cells, and this is the tissue called xylem. In the plants, xylem is the special tissue mainly meant for transport of water and minerals from the soil. And here, the thin pointed hair-like projections, I will draw it in a big size that it is very clear to understand. This is a hair-like projection of the root, and it is surrounded with soil particles, and there are gaps between the soil particles, and they are filled with soil water containing dissolved salts and minerals. This green color, what I am showing is the soil water. In this way, then how this water is absorbed? Plants do not have any water pump mechanism with the help of current, they can be run out. They themselves are absorbed. In every plant, xylem is the only tissue which can absorb soil water containing dissolved salts and minerals and sent to different parts of the plant. Let us see how it is operated. According to your previous information, each and every cell is having the jelly-like substance around the nucleus in the cell called cytoplasm. If you see the concentration of cytoplasm in each and every cell, it is highly concentrated when compared to the soil water around the root hair. Root hair also having highly concentrated solutions in the cytoplasm. According to the process of osmosis, which process? Osmosis process. What is the definition of osmosis? The movement of solvent molecules from high level to low level, or lower concentration to higher concentration through a semi-permeable membrane till the concentrations on both the sides becomes equal is called osmosis. Here, according to definition, you can understand that in the root hair, the concentration of the cytoplasm is more, means highly concentrated. Highly concentrated solution we can see in the root hair. And in the soil water, less concentration or lower concentration. You can see lower concentration water, soil water. And these red colored structures are soil particles. Soil particles. Now, according to the definition of osmosis, where to where the liquids will go, isn't it? Usually the liquids are moving from lower concentration water to highly concentration solution in the root hair, like this. If this happens, then what about the concentration of solutions in the root hair? It decreases when compared to the cells which are neighboring to the root hair cell. Here again, highly concentrated solutions. Highly concentrated solutions. Then when this is low concentrated, now the water moves into neighboring cell in this way. Like this, in this way. Like this, in this way. Like this, in this way. From here, like this, in this way. From here, like this, in this way. At last, they reach the cells of the xylem. This is the xylem. Xylem is made up of various cells, xylem vessels, xylem tracheids, xylem parenchyma, and fibers, etc. All these cells are receiving the soil water from adjacent cells in the root and forms a continuous flow of water, because water molecule and another water molecule are having the great affinity towards each other. great affinity towards each other means great attraction power towards each other to form a continuous water column. This water column creates a pressure in the root system to push the water up against the gravitational force of attraction. That pressure is called root pressure. The pressure with which the water is moving or transporting in the root against to the gravitational force of attraction is called root pressure. Then how this is generated? Due to the affinity between the water molecules combined together form a continuous water column creating the pressure against the gravitational pull is called root pressure, and it is pushing the water to up. In this way, from the root hair, the water is absorbing into the root of the plant body. This is the information and mechanism related to the absorption of water and mineral salts with the help of root hair in the soil. I hope you understood this topic, and thank you one and all. Have a nice day.